Hi guys, this is Miss Karen and I'm going to be your instructor for today. Our lesson is on lighthouses. Lighthouses are very important to ships at sea because they tell the captains that land is near. How do they tell them? By the light. On a foggy night, a captain may not see someone waving to them to go around, but they can definitely see the light from a distance. So lighthouses have to be really tall and have lots of windows at the top for the light to come out of. They're often round because there's a lot of wind on the shore and it helps the wind swoop around rather than smacking straight into the building. So for today's lesson, we're going to make a canvas of a lighthouse. I have done this before. I love this lesson. So I hope you enjoy it too. What you're going to want to do is get your canvas and take a look at your canvas. You have wood wrapped in this funny feeling, it's called canvas. It's like a fabric. It's been painted white, and the way you can tell it's been painted white is this is the actual color of your canvas. It's kind of a wheat color or cream. It's a little speckled with little natural colors from the fabric. They've painted it white and they've stapled it all the way around so it doesn't come off of the wood. You notice the sides have not been stapled. That means you can paint your painting all the way around. Now you don't have to paint the back, that's going to be up against your wall, but the sides can still be seen. So you want to make sure that when you paint this part, you also paint this in these parts. Okay? So the next thing you're going to need is a pencil, and I just use a regular pencil, nothing special, not one of my artist pencils, just a regular pencil. Now it's very important to know that you do not want to press hard when you draw on canvas. Even though canvas feels like it's hard, you can actually make a hole, and you don't want to do that. So we're going to draw super duper softly. Now, if you have a hard time drawing super duper softly, pick up a finger or two. If you draw like that, or even like that, you can't put a lot of pressure on your pencil. So that means you don't press hard. Okay, so we're going to start off with our pencil. We're going to start by looking at our land line. What we need to do is gently draw where our grass is going to go. Nothing hard. Do not put pressure on this. Then we're going to come up a little bit and we're going to draw where our water is going to go. So basically you have two lines drawn, so three sections. You have your land, your sea, and your sky. Let's go ahead and draw our lighthouse and then we will draw everything behind it. So in this bottom part, draw a smile. See that? Just a smile. Now in the sky, about halfway up, see this is our sky, remember? About halfway up, I want another smile, but this one's going to be a little bit smaller than this one. See that? It's not quite the same size. This one's bigger, this one's smaller. What we'll do now is connect them with a straight line on both sides. Got it? Now everything inside can be erased. We can add one, two, three smiles. One, two, three smiles. And in each smile, we want a window, which is a circle. And in the last one, a door, which is an upside down U. Now at the top, we have a little walkway. Our lighthouse man needs a place to walk. So we want to make our smile come out just a little bit on both sides. Come straight up just a little and do another line. Up here, we're going to make a small smile. You notice my smiles aren't big, giant ones. It's kind of like a smirk. Just a little bit of a curve. And we're going to come into a triangle. If you want to put a little ball on the top, you can. Now come straight down. We're going to do the glass part. That's where the light from the lighthouse comes out. So you have just drawn your lighthouse. If you'd like to draw some lines, just a few, not a bunch, you can. And if you'd like, if you have a big curve here and it looks almost like a boat, you can draw another line that comes up like that. And now it really looks round. Do you see that? It looks like he could literally walk behind there and come out this side. For our grass, we're just going to do a little bit of a rough line. For our water, we're going to make some peaks. Bump, bump, bump. And those are just basically smiles touching each other. Smile, 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 smile. We'll draw a little boat in the distance. So let's come up at a slight angle on both sides, kind of like that. Close it off with a smile. Straight line up. Curve. And from the same points, I want it to do the exact same thing, but a little bit smaller. Point to point. So I made like a banana. The last thing we're going to draw are clouds. We're going to start with a straight line and a straight line. Come up into a bump. Bump. And a big bump. And it goes off the page. Let's do it again. Bump. Bump. Big bump. But this one doesn't go off the page. This one's going to go bump, bump. And the last thing you can do off in the distance are little birds. See how I did that? I just did a frown touching a frown. Frown, frown. It's just that simple. All right, you guys, the next part is going to be painting. So we're going to pause here, get our supplies out, and then we will finish up. Okay, my friends, it's time to start painting. What I like to use are recycled plates. It looks like a really gross plate, doesn't it? Looks like it's filled with paint, crusty, gross. It's all dry. See that? It's dry. I recycle plates because it's important for us to remember that wasting hurts the environment. So anytime in art that you can reuse something or repurpose it, that's a good thing. Now you have your paints in these lovely, in your own lovely little containers. I have them in big, giant tubes and stuff. So I'm going to put mine on a plate. You do not need to do this, but if you feel the need, you can, but it's not necessary. So I've got a bunch of colors here, and let me get my green. And now we can get started. It is important that you have a water container for your brushes. Fill it about halfway up with water. Do not overfill it, because if you do, you could very easily spill it. And paint water is really, really a bad thing, especially for your mom or dad's carpet, because sometimes the paint is acrylic and it doesn't come out. All right, so we have our paint. We have our picture. You're gonna want a rag or napkin. It's very important to know how to wash and dry your brushes. Right now it's in water, right? It's drippy. That'll get everywhere. If I dip it in my paint, I'm gonna make watercolor paint, and that's not what I want to do. So I'm going to start off by pulling it out of my water, drag it gently on the side of my bucket, take my napkin or my rag, gently drag it till it's dry. Do not dab it ever, or you'll give your brush a bad hair day. It'll look like Miss Karen in the morning. That's not pretty. All right, so let's get started. We're gonna start with the furthest thing first. Any idea what that would be? It would be the sky. So I want my water darker than my sky. You may want the opposite. You may want crystal blue water and a stormy sky, but I would like a nice, beautiful blue sky. So I'm going to take a little bit of my blue, or I'm sorry, a little bit of my white and a lot of my blue and mix them up. This is called blending. It is key to know that once you have blended a color, you cannot unblend it. I'm going to fill my picture. I'm going to put my paint only where I want that color. I'm going to smooth out all of my goops. I'm going to paint my sides. I'm going to fill in all of the little white pieces that are throughout your painting, little cracks and crevices. And I'm going to just take my time. It's not a race. It is not about finishing this picture as fast as possible, because you know what happens when you finish it really quickly? You don't have anything else to do. So why not take your time and make it look good? All right, so Miss Karen's going to finish her sky. I'm going to pause the video. When you get back to the video, you will see that my sky will be completely done. So yours should be completely done. Just the sky. All right, so let's go ahead and pause. All right, my friends, finished my sky. I still have a dirty brush here. I didn't clean it. So let's go ahead and clean our brush. We're gonna put our brush in our water and we're gonna stir it like it's chocolate milk. Notice I didn't pick up my container. I'm just going to stir it while it's sitting on the table. I'm making sure that my brush is tapping on the bottom of my bucket. The reason I'm doing that is because that loosens up all of the paint that is stuck up in the barrel. So tap, tap, tap. Now I'm not jabbing it. I'm just tapping it gently. Now remember, drag it up the side of your bucket gently. Do it a few times. Come to your rag. Gently wipe it. And it's ready for your next color. Now, oddly, well, not oddly, but funny, our next color is blue. We really technically did not have to clean our brushes, but I did want to show you how to do it, so that's okay. All right, so we're going to paint this next part, which is your water, blue. I'm going to take your time and really fill it in. If you'd like to add some waves of white, you can. As soon as I get this filled in, I'll show you how to do that. Let me fill it in. You're going to want to take your time filling it in. Once again, it's not a race. You notice I'm going side to side for my brush strokes in little wave-like motions. It looks kind of like water. All right, so if you want to add some waves while it's still wet, I'm going to dip a little bit of white in my brush, tap in some smiles, and just keep doing it till they just sort of blend away, but not too much away. You want to see a little bit of it. But now you have a little bit of white crusting in there. Let's do the other side. Notice also I'm not dragging my hand over wet paint, keeping my hands on the dry side. Fill it in. Get all the little white speckles. You know what I'm talking about when you're painting this and you can see them. It's little bits of canvas that are sticking out. They don't fill on their own, so fill them in yourself. Touch my white, smiles. Keep adding smiles all over. There we go. I'm going to clean my brush, drag it on the side, dry it, and it's time for some grass. Fill in your grass. Now I'm going to pause the video, let you get your grass painted, because there's no special tricks to the grass. It's just a simple fill-in. When we get back, I'll show you the next part. So let's pause the video now. Okay, so now I have painted my sky, my water, and my grass. My grass is still wet, so you have two options. You can blow dry it. And when you blow dry your canvas, anything shiny becomes matte. Matte is another word for not shiny. So if it's not shiny anymore, like your sky, then it's dry. The other option is just turn it around, because I just don't want to run my hands into the wet area. So I'm cleaning my brush, dry my brush. And now I want to come in here with that blue again. And I want to just use the tip of your paintbrush. Notice I'm not bending my bristles. If you bend your bristles, you get a big fat line. I'm not bending them. I'm using the very, very tip to make a skinny, skinny line. And I'm outlining my clouds. Because honestly, I think pencil lines showing through are not very pretty. In my art, if you like it, then of course keep it, but I'm not a big fan of it, so I'm gonna go ahead and paint in the outlines, whoops, of my clouds very gently, smooth as I can, no big blobs. Take your time. Sometimes it's hard to do a straight line. You want to know the best way to do a straight line? Hold your breath. I know that seems kind of silly, but when you breathe, your hand moves, right? So if you hold your breath, your hand doesn't move. So that's just a little hint for you. All right, so I have just outlined my clouds. I'm going to turn it to the side. I'm going to touch my black, because I think I'm going to keep my boat white. And since my canvas is already white, all I really need to do is outline my boat. There we go, there's my boat. Now I painted over my straight line. So, there we go. And one more. We have a white boat. Turn it the other way. I can just barely see my little birds. There we go. Now let's go ahead and fill in the windows. I'm going to wash my brush. I'm going to grab my yellow, and with my yellow, I'm going to fill it in just a little bit, but I don't want it like super bright. So I'm only going to put a little bit, and then I'm going to touch my water and use it as a watercolor. Look at that. A whole lot of paint there. There you are. Wash your brush really well. Dry your brush. Now I'm coming back to my paint. Black and white. Do you know what that makes? It makes gray. Now, if you put a lot of black, is it going to be a dark gray or a light gray? A lot of black makes a dark gray. A little black makes a light gray. So you're going to want to decide if you want dark gray or light gray window and doors. There's no wrong answer. Totally up to you. Okay, so I did my door. Now I want to do my windows. You can do this two ways. You can paint it, or you can do the really super fun way. Dip your finger in your gray and make little tiny circles. See, I told you that was a more fun way. Okay, now I'm going to come in here with my black and white again, but this time I want a lot of white and a touch of black. Barely any in there. I'll turn my canvas around. I know it's a lot of flip-floppy. It's just because Miss Karen's lazy and doesn't want to blow dry the other side. I'm just kidding. I'm just trying to show you that there's ways to keep painting even if something is wet. So now I'm going to fill in this whole thing, but I gotta make a mental picture of what it looks like. A mental picture means I need to take a picture with my mind because I'm gonna have to redraw this. Fill it in. Alright, so now we're going to redraw it. Remember, there was that smile here. And it came in this way. And it came in this way. If you're not comfortable using your paintbrush as a pen, you can wait and do this with a Sharpie at the end of the lesson when it is completely dry. I like to challenge myself, and I'm pretty sure that you guys are good enough artists too to be able to challenge yourselves too. There you go. I'm also going to go ahead and do my windows. The last thing we want to do is the red part of the lighthouse. Sorry, I couldn't remember what it was called. I kept wanting to say boat. The red part of the lighthouse needs to be the part that you have the most. So right now, if you count, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sections. Well, you can't split 5 in half. I can't do 1, 2, and a half of 1. So, I'm going to do red, white, red, white, red. If you happen to do it the other way, is that wrong? Absolutely not. You know, for that matter, if you don't want a red lighthouse, does it have to be red? Nope. Now, if you're trying to make it look like most lighthouses look, then you may want to go with the red because typically they are red. Sometimes they're black and white. Sometimes they're other colors. But majority of them are red and white, and that's because they need to be seen. But that doesn't mean you have to. I've had students that make them rainbow colored. I've seen students do blue and white. I've seen them pink and purple. I've seen them every kind of way you can possibly think of. So, there's just really not a wrong way to do art. You're the artist. You're the only one that knows what you want it to look like. You're telling us a story with your art. You're telling us that you have this building, and there is a boat in the water, and your boat is trying to get to safety, and you have created this wonderful lighthouse, and there's a little family that lives deep inside this little lighthouse, and that daddy goes up there whenever he sees that boat in the distance, and he turns on the light, and that boat off in the distance safely makes it to shore, all because you created it that way. Pretty cool, huh? You know, if you wanted to take this one step further, after our painting lesson, you could always write a story. Tell me about this lighthouse. Where is it? What's the name of the family that lives in there? Do they have any pets? Do they have kids that are your age that go to school down the street? You can write a whole story about this. So use your imagination. Take your time. Finish painting it. But if you're not done being creative, or if you feel inspired, make a story. Use this as the cover of your book. You could redo this on a piece of paper. I'm sure Mom or Dad can staple it together. And of course, I want to see your finished products because I love to see your artwork. And I try to put your artwork on our website. And then you're famous. Alright, so the last part that I'm going to finish is the very top. And I'm still spinning it around and around because it is still wet. I'm going to come in here, paint my little topper, take my time. And once I finish this, there's only one last thing to do. Do you know what that is? Outlining the rest of the lighthouse. Using your brush very gently. Spin it around. I don't think I'm going to outline the actual inner smiles that we did. I think I'm going to leave them and the windows as is. If you decide you would like to outline them more, or if you'd like to add flowers to the grass, or more birds in the sky, whatever you want to do, this is where you can become as creative as you want to and go ahead and finish it up. I think I might add a little bit of black to the windows. All right, when you finish your artwork, it is always important as the artist to sign your art. So pick a color, come to the bottom. I put my initials, which is the first letter of my first and last name. You can sign just your first name, you can sign your nickname, you can sign it however you want to. I really enjoyed doing this project with you guys today. I hope you did too. Our lighthouses are absolutely adorable, and I really do hope that you'll send me pictures of your art, and we'll put it on the website. Have a wonderful day, my friends, and we'll see y'all soon. Bye.